change, and a left vacuum pump has failed on it, so we're going to change that. And I just got done running it, so I got the temps up. It's really nicely laid out, nice digital panel the whole way. This thing is a sweet machine. We've been working on it for a long time. So let's get her shut down here in the hangar. Sounds good. All right, we'll get out there and get the oil changed on it. Okay, engine's uncowled here. I have to get underneath here. First thing I gotta do, gosh darn it, I keep forgetting things. That's probably because I'm getting old. I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna take some of this cleaner here. And I'm just gonna spray it through my hose because I'm gonna be pulling a sample off this thing, and I don't want anybody else's old crappy oil messing my sample up on this one. So let's see if I can catch this. No, I probably won't because I need like more than six hands to do any of this. Here's the spray little nozzle. We do get in the bucket there. Go on, get in there. Okay, I'll spray this down in here. Clean this hose out a bit. There, she's coming out now. Yeah, wash her around a little bit. There you go. Get some of that. Just clean some of the crap out that was in there. And then, sorry about the camera, but it's just, this is how it goes. I mean, I gotta get up there. There's the drain. And gotta make sure it's in a bucket. Otherwise, I'm gonna be wearing everything here. I don't want to wear the old dirty oil because you know why? It's hot. Okay. So I got the hose on there. Hose goes up to a little hole here. Goes up here. You reach up there and get this thing. Hang on a second. I'm going to have to set you down. Hope you don't mind. I'll put you on my foot. How's that? No, that's not going to work. Okay, hold on. Hold on now. I'm going to put you there and then I'll get this. Okay, there we go. All right, so what I did is I pushed that guy up and it's coming out the hose down here into the bucket. I'm gonna let drain for a couple seconds here and then I'll go over here. I got my sample jar. Reminds me of the military, if you know what I mean. Giving samples all the time. That's what happens when you serve on a submarine. They don't want you doing any of that crazy stuff, you know. It's all legal now in most states. Okay, so got quite a bit of oil going down in here. I'm just gonna pull a sample. There we go. That's more than enough. And it's hot. I got this oil up to about 180 degrees. So it's pretty warm. I'll clean this off. And then I'm gonna set it over my box. That will be for the left engine. And this oil filter, take that off. And then this here is the vacuum pump that has failed. So I'm gonna be pulling that off and changing it. So that's so far for the left engine. I'll head over to the right, get the cowl off, and we'll be back. Okay, the right engine is uncowled. I don't have to take the top cowl off for this because this part here, I don't have to take that off because we're just doing an oil change on this side. The other side I took it off because I'm changing that vacuum pump. So I've already got the oil draining out. You can see her down there, she's draining. You might ask why would I be pulling oil samples if we're just gonna be changing these engines out in November? Well, these engines really running great. They're really running great, but they are past the time between overhaul. And that's the manufacturer's recommendation is you have to overhaul these engines. So, but what we're doing is we're just being proactive. So if the cam starts grinding down or lifters start going or something and they start making metal,
we want to see that. And the way to is by pulling the samples. So we sent them out to Blackstone. Shout out to Blackstone in Fort Wayne, Indiana. They do a great job. Very descriptive on their analysis and the reports that they give us on these samples. Inside here, I don't know where they went to. There's, oh, maybe it's inside here now. But there's a sheet I'll fill out with times. Obviously the aircraft and engine times, time between the oil, and if any oil is added in between, so they can really do an analysis on it. They do a great job, and we've had a couple times where they've, I was saying that they found things before, and we've actually gone and looked for problems and had to pull engines. We found a, they found some wear metals in one, and they said, man, you might want to check the cam. And so we pulled the push tubes out and got a flashlight up in there and looked, and sure enough, the cam lobes were ground down on one. That was quite a while ago, but yeah, it's good to do an oil sample. I recommend it for not every oil change on an airplane, but you know, gosh darn it, it's cheap insurance to see what your oil's doing. So we do it, and it's just good. We trend them, so we can see how the oil's doing in the engines, see how the engine's wearing, things like that. So it's pretty good, and it's like I said, it's cheap insurance. Frequent oil changes is another key to longevity in an airplane engine's life. So we do frequent oil changes. If you look at this. That's our oil, drain oil, and that's only from, I want to say, like probably 4 months ago, and that's a 300 gallon tote, I believe. So we really notch her up here. So anyway, I'm gonna get back to this oil change, and I'll show you a couple other things that I look at when I'm doing it, and we'll keep on plugging away. Okay, still plugging away here. I grab this here bucket. Let me put this on a little, you can see a little better. This is where it starts to get fun. So you see the filters up here. The bucket's down here. And you see all this area right here can turn into a big old flipping mess. Which it's probably going to anyway. Anyway, I'm gonna snip this off here. Safety wire's gotta come off. Come on, get in there. Yeah, there we go. This one, yep. Yep, I'll get that later. Don't worry about it. I will get it later. Stop calling me out. Safety wire here. It's going into the garbage right away, not like on the floor like everybody else likes to do. Get my wrench. I left it over here because I grabbed the phone camera instead. So grab this and then come back over back around here. Okay, and then actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go get my camera stand and I'll put you on that so you can watch what I'm going to do. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, so basically get the filter off without making a huge mess. I put what we call the green weenie underneath here. And so it's gonna direct the oil that's gonna come on from the bottom of the filter. I'm gonna direct it down into the bucket that I have down here. It's hot out, and I heard that if you drink hot coffee when it's hot, it actually cools you. I don't think it's true. But I heard it, you know what? I probably read it on the internet. I mean, anything you read or see on the internet, it's gotta be true. So I'm gonna take and pull this guy off. Start getting that oil coming down. Hopefully I don't wear too much of it. I did wear my Sunday best shorts. Yep, oh, it's hot. Okay. Oh, today. Hey, today's Friday, by the way. So that's like bonus. It's Friday.
All right, so I'm capturing a lot of the oil. It's good. I don't see anything coming down the backside. That's good too. All right, let's get this thing off of here. It's hot. Did I mention it's hot? Freaking hot. All right. They're off. Yeah, I'm still getting her off. Think it's ever gonna come off? I don't know. Well, at least it's not a Fram filter. Try that. Alright, put this bad boy down here. Wow. It's hot. But that's what you want. Hot oil drains better. Carries the crap out. Oh, see? Did you see? I was so close to success. And no, of course not. But didn't do too bad. Didn't make too bad of a mess. I'm gonna set that over here. Right there. Let me get my green weenie out of here. Because I get to go make a mess on the other side too. I'm gonna get a rag. Stay there. Stay there. Okay, so that really wasn't a surprise. I knew it was gonna be a mess. It always is a mess. It's oil change. So I'm gonna get my rag down in there. Slap some of this up here real quick. This, a little bit of that. You know, here, of course, it has to go every stinking way. Why wouldn't it? It's oil. Oh, didn't get too bad down here. That's good. Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's following the channel down. That's gonna make a little bit of a mess, but I'll trick it. Got a sprayer down here. Keep spraying. Nope, keep going. Okay, new rag. And then I gotta take this oil filter and I have to cut it open and inspect it. Because that's what we do on airplanes. Everything else looks good. The mating surface looks good here. I'm checking that out. When I put the new one on, it'll be good. Get this oil cleaned up. Crying out loud. You know, you gotta like when a plan does not come together. I mean, it came together, it rolls out. I guess that's part of the plan. But I don't like making a mess. Oh yeah, she's coming out. She's getting it all. Ow, that's hot. This is hot. Oh, that hot. I'd say what my friend Travis says, but I can't. It's not for children. I don't know if any of this is for children. I mean, who wants to watch this old guy? What kind of airplane is it? Ugh. Yeah, that's pretty good. Let me squirt a little bit down here. Do a little flush-a-roo. A little flush down here. A little over there. Yep. You got her. Yes. That's the difference between airplane mechanics, car mechanics. No offense to car mechanics, but I mean, I am huge into clean. Stuff's got to be clean. It's just... just makes everything easier. It's gotta be clean. Alright, so anyway, that's about it. I'm gonna find a clean section on here. And I'm just gonna jam her into here. And that'll keep it from flipping. Stop flipping oil. Okay. So that's pulling a oil filter off and, you know, not making a mess. Everything's a mess, okay? Just admit it. The sooner you admit it, the sooner you can accept the fact that it's gonna be messy. All right, I'm gonna go cut this filter open. So I don't know, do you wanna see that? You wanna see me cut the filter open? Yeah, what the heck, I'll take you over there. Hang on. Okay, guys, gals, family, friends and fans, welcome back. So I went ahead and pulled the left one off too.
you'd be happy to know that I didn't make quite as much of a mess as I did on the right one, but it's still a few drips got away. That's okay. It's easier to clean when there's just a few drips. So basically what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna take this contraption here and spin it around on top of this thing. Let me crank it down a little more. And pull this oil filter apart. Alright, almost off. Okay, there's that. So, this thing off, and I'll slice myself open. So that's what the inside of it looks like. Kinda. It's got a little rubber gasket. That's where it screws on and seals to the airplane. And then this is the inside of the filter. It's pretty stout, pretty heavy. Pretty heavy duty. And this here is the filter element. I'm just gonna pull it out slowly because it's still got oil in it. This is probably the most well-lubed vise on the planet. As you can tell, it just gets lubed. It doesn't even want lubed when it gets lubed. This oil is just everywhere. That's okay. I mean, you can see, I don't know if you can see down here, but there's welds down here, there's welds up here. This thing's been around a while. Somebody welded it. I mean, glob welded, but it's still a weld, I guess. It's still draining. These things hold a lot of oil. These things hold probably about a good half a quart to a three quarters of a quart of oil in them. So when we service it back up, we have to account for that when we go ahead and put oil in back in the engine. And I'll take this and just dump it here into the bucket. And that goes in the garbage. And as long as I'm mess making, I'll get the right one here. This is the left one. Park over here. I'll park it on top of here. It's just a mess. This oil is just everywhere. It's the lifeblood of engines, though, just so you know. Don't forget about it with your car either. Change your oil frequently in your car and your airplane. It's just good. It's just good for it. You know, a lot of these synthetics go 10,000 miles. I don't know. I don't know if I like that 10,000 mile thing in a car. I don't. I don't do mine. I do mine every, like in my one Mercedes, it's 10,000 miles and I do it at about four. I don't know. Too much crap in the oil or in the gas and stuff, the burning, all the combustion materials and everything that stays in there. And, you know, for 10,000 miles, that's a lot of crud running around inside your engine. Okay, same thing. Garbage. Seal, garbage, and we'll let this thing drain. We're lubricating the vise, that's what I mean. My hands are really crappy, so I'm gonna go and grab a rag. Be right back. All right, coolest thing is I got halfway to my box and it's fumbling on the ground. So I'm using that. Perfect. So again, let's drain this sucker out. Remember, this is the right one. I'm gonna put that back on a cutter. The left one I have sitting on another filter that needs to get cut open from a different oil chain that somebody else is doing. Okay, that's that. Yes, probably use this thing. It doesn't work the greatest, but it works. Yeah, let's see what we got here. Oh yeah, this guy. Okay, so this thing here, it really's got to be tight. Okay, I took my filter and oil, everything else, and somehow it's supposed to go on here. I haven't used this thing too much. Maybe it doesn't go on here. I don't know. Oh, what's this thing? I didn't see this. It is for a different type of filter. It's not gonna work. Alright, well. I didn't want to do it the old. I got it too tight now. I did not want to do it like this because it just seems like it's, I don't know, not the greatest way to do it. I mean, we've been doing it forever like this. That's right. The old venerable hacksaw. Okay, I just grabbed the right one because it's closer at the time at this moment. And I'm gonna saw the metal plate down. You know, you can see that there's a metal that puts the pleats together for the filter. And I'm just gonna go around the circle. Don't get any oil line at all on this. Almost there for one side. Yeah, that's one side. Now, other side. Hey, you wanted to see this, so you gotta hang in there. So this is what we do. Okay, getting down. Coming around again. I won't bore you with doing on both of them. I'll just show you the one here. Okay, coming around again. Now what I do is I gotta get this filter insides out. Ta-da! So this don't need it. This guy here, I'm taking this, open this up. And this is where's my turret? I'm gonna pull this off right here. Okay, there goes that little piece that holds it together. Bring this all together like this, if I can. Maybe I'll hold the accordion effect. Wee, wee, wee. Having fun now. Oiliness alert. Okay, so I'm gonna open this up. This is where it gets fun. You don't have to do this, I just do it because it helps you visually see what's going on inside the filter, but I'm just gonna hold this like this and I'm gonna squeeze her down, and I don't know if you can see it. We got a lot of oil out of it. So do it just a little bit more. Squeeze down, get a little bit of this oil out. And then if there's any contaminants in there, I can see them just that much better. So just give her another little squeeze here. Okay, so she's squeezing out, oil's coming out of it. I'm gonna wipe my hands off again. So basically what I'm doing is I'm looking for any metal that could be in it. And mostly it's just probably gonna be just carbon and stuff from the engine running. So let me pop this back open. Okay, here we go. Let's just do an inspection. She's clean. A little carbon here, just a little tiny bit. Nothing. There's nothing shiny. So nothing shiny is good. We don't want shiny stuff. Just open it up there. I mean, there's nothing to even put a magnet on. If you see metal, I'll run a magnet. But I mean, there is nothing here to even put a magnet on to see if it's ferrous or not. This looks really good. So the right engine. Right engine is doing really good. It's not making any metal. Jeez, I mean, that's perfect. You know what that does? That gives me a smiley face. That's a big smiley face. Gives me a smiley face because that means this engine's doing really good, and I'm happy for the owner on that. So anyway, I'm gonna run, wipe my hands off, and I'm gonna stop here. I'm gonna do the other filter, and then I'm gonna get the filters back on and fill oil up and stuff like that. So I don't wanna bore you with all that, but this is what we do on oil change. Not hard, just time consuming and a little bit messy. All right, we'll catch you. All right, did the right filter, or I guess I did left filter, opened it up. It looks good, as the right one did. So we're good there. Put the new filter on, and it's torqued on, about 16, 18 foot-pounds torqued on. Just went in, got the times. Let me go grab my Sharpie. my Sharpie. So this engine on this side, left tack, is 1904. So we'll put today's date, which, what is today's date? I don't even know what today is. What's today's date? 23? So 6/23/23, today's date. I'm gonna put the left tack time on here. Left tack. And I'm writing it like this so that anybody that looks at it can see it pretty clearly. And that's gonna be 8. And then what we usually write on here is we'll write what kind of oil we're putting in it, which this is Phillips. W50XC. And then right here, I'll put with Vanguard. All right. So that's all the information. So if somebody else changes it, say he's down in Florida or wherever he's at, they have the time on it. When we change the oil last, the date, what kind of oil we used, and then we used cam guard. And this is the cam guard right here. That's a additive we put in for corrosion, and it also coats the cam and other engine parts. So on startup, it doesn't wear exponentially on startup, which is the whole deal. Got my safety wire here. I'm going to safety the oil filter. I'm going to go down there and close the drain. And then I will add oil, and this side oil change will be finished. I do have to fill this out, because that's for the oil sample. And I'll carry on. I don't know how much time is on it since the last oil change. I'll have to go into his logbooks and check and see when we did it last. And write that down, and then we should be good. So anyway, just gets safety around here. I'm gonna go down to that's righty tighty lefty loosey. I'll do that one. And we'll get this side finished up, oil in it, and then I gotta get up here, change that filter or that pump, and I have a Rapco replacement pump to install. Rapco is actually our neighbor here. They are up in Heartland. They make vacuum pumps, they make filters, they make brake discs, they make brake pads, they make fuel pumps, they make all kinds of stuff for airplanes. So whenever we can, we elect to use them. And no, I don't get paid to say that. I've just been friends with them a long time. I've been at it a little bit here. I've been fixing airplanes for a little while, long time. I got my license to fix airplanes and 1989. Seems so long ago. It is long ago. Anyway, this is an oil change. Just wanted to show you guys what it's all about. And I don't know. It's good. It's good. This thing on here. Man, nice and tight. Spin it backwards here. This end. I'm put a little curlicue on it so that the next guy who sticks his hand in here doesn't get his arm ripped off by the safety wire, because this stuff is flipping sharp. Okay, so that's that. I will, I don't think you need to watch me put oil in it, do you? No? Just know I'm going to put oil in it. And then I'll put you up on top here somewhere. I don't know. See if I can get you to see the vacuum pump, and I get the vacuum pump changed. So, all right. See you on the other side of that.
All right, so the engines are full of oil and that cam guard additive that I told you about. Now I'm changing this vacuum pump that failed. And this pump here, it's basically an air pump. And it just makes high pressure air. And what we do with that air is blow up the de-ice boots on this thing. He's got all glass panel in here now, so he doesn't have any instruments that require air. And he only needs this for his boots, de-ice boots. Not super critical now because it's, 85 degrees out, but that's what he does use that for. So I'm changing the pump out, and I'll show you that process. And it's only four nuts, but they're four fun nuts to get to because it's an airplane. Why not make them fun? So, all right, I'll copy in on the rest of it. Oil change is done. I get this done, be able to take the airplane out, run it, and get it back home today. He'll be happy for that. And I still got that 172 sitting over there I'm doing a hinge on. Still waiting for the paint to get a little drier. I don't want to mess it up too bad. So, all right, we'll catch you on the other side of that. All right, everybody. Still getting this vacuum pump off here. Got the nuts loose, and then I've learned through years of experience, bring along your magnet, because otherwise things will drop and go off into infinity or infinity. I'm gonna tuck that in my pocket. And then this one here, same thing. I get it, I had the magnet, so the stuff doesn't drop to the abyss. Same thing down here. Oh, see, and I missed it. It flew off. You heard it hit. Heard it hit, but guess what? It went to the floor. Good. All right, now I gotta get the last one here. So I'm just changing this vacuum pump out. It's not that big of a job. Obviously it's sped up because you get to see it on film. I get to look at it in real time. Beautiful day out today. Everybody's out flying today. That's nice. That's what I like to see. Now I gotta see if I can clear this air box coming in. There we go. Oh yeah. Oh look. Here's the problem. Here's that end. And here's the little dually that makes it go spinny spinny. She's no good. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, well, looks like I got some gasket material to clean off of here. Yay. That's not gonna be fun. This thing's been on here for a New York minute. There's no date on it. I have to go into the logbooks and see if I can see when it was put on. But it's probably been on here a while, judging from the gasket that's welded itself to the engine. So I gotta go get my scraper. And I'll clean all that off, and we'll get the new pump on. I've got to blow the lines out. I've got to replace the filter. As a matter of fact, as you hear, if you want to see, I'll bring you over here. I'm going to open this guy up here. And let me get the other screw. Open this guy up here. There's a filter. I think there's a filter in here that I have to change after I blow the lines out, place all the filters for the system. It's not as critical now as it is if it has instruments, but still to practice. You clean the lines out so you don't get gunk that backfeeds up into the new one. All right, well, he only has an inlet filter, so that's fine. Yeah, so that's it. I will get the new pump on, and you can see what I'm talking about here. Let me get this down. That's where the gasket is. That's the drive. They pack quite a bit of stuff. I think if you guys remember from seeing the T-34, it has a bunch of stuff just like this. I mean, it has the same kind of starter. It's a Continental engine. So I'll get that pump on, and I get the gasket cleaned up first. But it's lunchtime, so I'm thinking probably gonna zip off to lunch. Adam made me go back there and do some inspection on that Cirrus, which I did, got that done. And now we're gonna be getting the hinge put on that 172 right after I'm done here. So gotta get this done and get that airplane back to them. They need it for flight instruction. And so I'll catch you guys later. I probably won't be back until we're out running this thing and delivering this back to its customer. So, all right, or its owner, I mean. Okay, catch you. All right, I'll show you this here. I've got the flange cleaned off. That was a little bit of a bugger. Gosh darn, this stuff just is never easy. You can see there's all the crud I got off. I mean, that thing was like welded on there. I don't understand what the heck. It was just like on there. So, all right, now we, here, this is a new gasket looks like. Ta-da, brandy new. All right, I'm gonna set this down here. Yeah, I'll throw around a wide mode so you can see what's happening. And then, put this bad boy on. I got a little bit of a step here. Let's see. All right, so, let's see. I want the gasket like this. All right, and then I put the pump on. It's got to face this way because that's where the fittings go. It's got to be fitting on. Oh, isn't that clever? They put a little cutout there so it can actually go on there. So I rotate this just a scotch. Well, she slides in there to drive. Eh, come on. Why cotton picker? Everything's got to be so difficult. I don't have any clue. I'm turning it just a tiny hair because I don't want to go too far. You'd think it would go on by now. Yeah, she's getting close. Or maybe I'm not even turning it. That could be what's happening. Oh, okay, I must have been turning it. So it went on. So you reach in here. Get a couple of the little hardly awares out. And see if I can put these on without dropping stuff down into Kingdom Come. That's one. Get the Knutsky on there. Okay. What's going on? Alright. Well, hey, you know, I made this video because when my family came out for my daughter's wedding, they're like, hey, you don't have any new videos. And then I was talking to my friend Leanne out in California, and she's like, you don't have any new videos, you must be busy. And I'm like, yep, the boys are making me work on airplanes. And then I thought today, I was like, you know what, I should probably make a video of just doing this. Why the heck not? So that's why I'm making this. And I don't know, again, it's interesting to me. Well, this is just work. Adam's making me work today. Yesterday I kind of messed up. I probably should have done a video of replacing a cylinder on a little Cessna 150, but I didn't. So, you know, we don't get to see that because I didn't do it. I didn't make a video of it. Adam was gonna go over to Food Truck Friday with me, and then he bailed on me. He didn't want to go. I was kind of sad about that because I thought Food Truck Friday would be fun. But no, let's not do Food Truck Friday. Nope.
You talking about me over here?
Yeah, you didn't want to go to Food Truck Friday with me. So now guess what? I just didn't have lunch now. Thanks.
Why didn't you eat lunch?
Because nobody used to go to Food Truck Friday with me.
Well, Booker brought back some.
He already had ordered online.
Did you go Arby's or?
He ordered online. He's doing Cousins today. Yep, he's being healthy.
Remember like a month ago when he almost died? He's gonna eat better?
He is eating better. He's eating Cousins.
Today.
That's
yesterday was Arby's.
Arby's was yesterday with Bill?
Yeah.
No.
Who's eating out every day this week?
Ah, Bill.
Bless
his heart, Bill. Okay, I'm working on like the really, really hard one down here. You know, you really can't see the stinking thing, but you still gotta get a nut on it. That's the one. I'm trying to move these wires out of the way, but you know, they're so tight that they really don't want to move. Hey, you asked for this, and I'm providing. And don't use any of this as your basis for changing a vacuum pump or changing oil. If you're going to be doing that stuff, do it by the manual. I mean, I do it by the manual. But I also have, you know, what is this, 2023? I also have 34 years of experience doing this stuff, so that does help a bit. It doesn't help with this nut, because this nut's a little bit of a bugger. It's a bugger. Come on, Bessie, it wants to go on. That's what I always tell them. I say, you know you want to go on there, just get on. Just save us both the trouble and go on there. Go on. I'm trying to use my screwdriver to hold it up there so I can spin it with the finger that I can't feel anymore because it's being stretched to oblivion. No. No. Oh my gosh. Oh yeah, there we go. She's on. Watch what you say, Mark. You watch what you say. Mark's watching this so he can learn. Right, Mark?
Sure.
You're trying to learn.
I haven't done one or two of these before.
No, just one or two. All right, these got short studs on it for clearance issues, I'm sure.
What you do with the hinge?
Hmm?
Where's the hinge at?
The hinge is on the tail of this airplane baking in the sun. I'm trying to expedite its dryingness because everybody and their brother is calling from Stein's to get the airplane back. It should be ready to go. I put the other one on already. Just I didn't tighten it down though, the forward part. But so, oh, there it is. And then these guys go on like this. Do not put anything on the threads. You don't want to mess up your pump. Okay. Put this one on, get everything hooked up. I already blew everything out, so we're good there. I gotta tighten them down. I know I have to tighten them down. I should probably not even be putting this one on yet. I'm gonna wait on this one here until I tighten that down because I'll never get to it if that fitting's in. So hold on, please. Dun, dun, dun. Find the right wrench. Okay, for those of you who do work on stuff mechanic-wise, I gotta tell you that this is a snap-on 60-40 degree wrench. 60-40. It is like it's like the best wrench ever invented. I mean, it is absolutely, it does not get any better than this. I love my 60-40. If I didn't have my set of 60-40s, I would probably shrivel up and die. These wrenches have got me out of so many pickles. It's not even funny to think about. Like this pickle, like you can't even get in there. But you know what? The 60-40 does, it gets in there. It's in. It's tightening. It's turning. And then it's on a weird flat. I can go to the other side. This 60, 40. To the other side and get it with that one. Just what I want it. That's the only engineer in my life that I like. Is the guy that invented the 60-40. I mean, I don't want to say he's genius. I mean, he knows he's genius. But he's pretty freaking genius. 60-40. And no, I don't get paid to go tout on about Snap-on 60-40. I just love that wrench. It's so amazing. Because there's sometimes you just can't get on it with a regular one, and then you can get your 60 on, and then you can get your 40 on, and boom, it's just tightening or loosening. Just good stuff. You learn over the years what tools work, what tools don't work, and I'm telling you right now, 60-40 works. It does. It gets the job done. Right now, see, I can get the end on her and bring her up here, and there we go. Alright, now, this little guy here is going to, a little bit of a PIA. Get my wrench down underneath here, that's what the thing is. Da-da-da. There we go. And then the other end. There. Flip her over and you can get right on those flats that you just bombed out on. All right. One more time. Yeah. This wire is kind of a pain. It's a starter wire. Gotta have it. Gotta be able to start it. Gotta have a wire going to the starter. There you go. Oh yeah, Snap-on makes a wrench for this. Let's go see if I can find it. Oh, did I say Snap-on? I said Rapco? Rapco makes a wrench for this. I don't know what I said. I wasn't even listening to myself. I'm just rambling on. And that's what you get to listen to. Me rambling on. Okay, well, that's going to do it for this install. I'm going to put the other fitting on, get the hoses hooked up, new filter on, and call it a wrap. So I've got to get over there and we got to get that hinge going because they really are wanting to get that 172 back. So we got to get that done. I got to get this thing held back up. Got to run it, leak check it, function check this. Now we're good to go. So I'll probably post a little bit of my run up and that's gonna do it. But hey, thanks for hanging around, watching what I do, watching what we all do, and hope you enjoyed it. See you later. Okay, I'm out now. I'm going to start up the bearing here. You can see him outside. Oh, looks like somebody's delivering some parts. I'm gonna give this thing a go. First, I'm gonna put this headset on. Oh my gosh, I don't know. I mean, seriously, it's hot out, and it's hotter than Whitney Houston in The Bodyguard. I mean, that's how hot it is out here. Oh, but hey, you know what? When I get hot, I take and drink my sparkling ice. This water is some of the best I've had. I actually found it when I was out motorcycling, going to a gas station, and then, of course, I was really thirsty, so I'm like, I wanted a soda, and I'm like, no to soda. Go zero sugar, which is what I try to do. And I had this stuff. Oh my gosh. Let me, you're not even going to understand. Hang on now. Hold on. Hey, let me just show you what I'm talking about. Let me see here. There we go. All right. There we go. It's a little crooked. Okay, we're in an airplane. It's fine. Right now, a little more. There we go. Yes. Listen to this.
Oh yeah, that's the sound of refreshment. Move this out of the way. That is so good. In case you're wondering, no, I'm not endorsed. I don't get anything from them. I just love this water. It's so good. So anyway, down to business here. Let's get this thing started. I'm going to start the left engine first. Fuel on. You're not going to hear me in a second because this thing is loud. So here we go. Clear left. Adam's out for fire watch. Here we go. There she goes. All right, she's bouncy. And we got oil pressure. And the vacuum pump light is out. See you next time. See ya.